me know if that sounds any better. Let me know if that sounds, that's better. I turned down the game volume a little bit. Yeah, that's better. I can't blame you about losing track. I mean, I'm the guy that fell asleep. I mean, I don't even know what movie my girlfriend put on. I passed out. Like, just tired. Oh, yeah. That's some gameplay footage, and the beta of the game came out this weekend, so we got a chance to play through that. Angry Andy powered through and got like max level through beta and did everything that you can, helped us grab footage and all this other stuff, so it's probably one of our best produced videos so far. Out there, people see it and give us feedback and let us know, you know, if we gave enough information, if we didn't give enough information, you know, just kind of generally gauge how we're doing. Yeah, the beta was for Xbox One, and then the PC one started last night. So the Xbox One one started Thursday, I think it was. So we jumped on with that. love having people's feedback. No opinions, you know, like what you like, what you don't like. Yeah, give us as much feedback and communicate with us as much as you can. We love that stuff. I mean, it's what we do for our show. That's what we're looking for. I mean, comment on everything that you watch from us, even if it's, you know, just watching a video. I put a question out there asking people what games on the retro run. If there's a game that you want to see us play or something you want to see us review, definitely let us know. Totally. Provide content to that gaming site. Even if we do that deal, the regular weekly show is not going to change. It may evolve and get better as far as quality wise, but the core show is not going anywhere. That's staying the same. But definitely, you can expect to see a lot more content from us. Interviews and little short 5-minute clips and reviews, previews, tons of stuff. I've been playing for the past for like 2 days, and I'm all the way into the dark world, so I'll probably pick back up where I left off with that and continue playing that. Once we finish up Super Mario RPG, unless there's something else that catches my eye that I haven't played in a long time. Oh yeah, the basic show is always going to stay the same. That's never going to change. You know, we may dress it up and like the video production of it be a little bit more fancier, a little better looking. Because we want to put the best quality that we can. So you'll probably see like a better camera. Like to get it where pictures change, like so, like close-ups and stuff, things like that. But the regular show's not going anywhere, not changing. That's gonna always be there. That's always gonna stay the same. The 4Compatible podcast is about video games, and it's gonna be us sitting around talking about video games that we always have. What we are gonna do though is we're gonna start doing, like I said, these little mini episodes, mini clips and stuff. We want to branch out. We want to talk about video games and movies, comic books, TV shows, board games, card games. Really encompass everything that we can cover. But, you know, at the top of that, the flagship show will be 4Compatible Podcast, which is about video games like it always has been. But we're going to branch out and start covering more topics as little side videos and projects and things like that. Maybe a little side podcast here and there. But working on some stuff. We've got some stuff in the pipeline. We're nervous because, I mean, it's a big deal. But we should have a lot of people coming out here in the next couple of months, especially once we get on board with the Gamers Gathering and get our content out there on their site and stuff like that. As far as what I consider retro, I'd say all the way up to like GameCube. I know that's kind of cheating, but I do have GameCube emulators and stuff that I can do. I've got a PS1 emulator, but I don't have a PS4 yet. I even have a PSP. I prefer to stick to like the 16-bit era, but I mean, I'll delve into N64 and stuff like that. Definitely down the line, I'm going to get to Majora's Mask and probably Ocarina of Time and stuff like that. But I go for my 16-bit nostalgia games. But I recommend something. If there's something that you really want to see me play, I know we had that one play session with Oscar, and we always have to put Oscar here and make him play games just because he's not really a gamer. So it's kind of fun to watch somebody who doesn't know what they're doing play. But if it's something I'm interested in, I'll tell you. Which make the game fun and interesting. I guess it's more along the lines of content. Like, I'll play a Super Mario RPG or Pokemon because I find those interesting. But like the traditional, like difficult stories of your standard JRPG, I just have this interest. I mean, I played Dragon Quest, I played Blue Dragon, I played Final Fantasy. Hard to get my attention with those. Pokemon story and Mario story are pretty straightforward. They don't get complicated. And I think that's what I like about it. Is that it's easy to follow along what's going on. And they're just fun to play. Favorite series of Pokemon, I guess. Generation of Pokemon. do it in Yellow Red. That's awesome. I'm actually thinking about doing Yellow as a retro red. Did you see that? He stopped and looked at it before running. Coins and my XP. Stop it. Now, or should I go explore more?
Thank you.
Save and run.
Thank you.
I'm awesome. I'll go with I'm awesome. Let's go. out above the door where Birdo was, too. Look at, I remember. See?
Thank you.
Alright. How do I get that box? There it is. Damn it! Hey, how's it going? this way. Is that right? Just the lazy shells? And I'm slaying. And then I gotta go to the hot springs, right?
Thank you.
I just looked over and saw all this text. No, it's not, dude. I don't care. It ain't no big deal. I should keep that the lazy shell on Mario though, right? Buy everybody else the fire outfits. Lazy shell on Mario. Thank you.